In this video, we're going to talk about scarce goods, free goods, and economic bads. Microeconomics focuses on how individuals and societies allocate scarce goods. A scarce good, by definition, also known as an economic good, is a good for which the total amount that people would like to consume is greater than the amount that would be supplied when the price is zero. Keep in mind that last part of the statement about the zero price. Don't confuse a concept of a scarce good with the concept of a shortage or a surplus. A shortage or a surplus tells us what happens at the current price, not at a price of zero. We'll address the concepts of shortages and surpluses in a later video. In determining whether a good is a scarce good, the only question that matters is whether there is enough of the good available at a price of zero to satisfy everyone who wants the good. A good is said to be a free good if there is enough available to satisfy everyone, even when the price is zero. In a sense, it's the opposite of a scarce good. There are very few goods that are truly free. Sunlight is perhaps the best example of this, at least for those of us who do not spend the winters in climates like that in Oswego, New York. Even though we don't pay for sunlight, we all receive enough to allow us to at least sustain life on Earth. Students will sometimes argue that water and air are free goods, but recall that we dump a lot of pollutants into our air and water. We have restrictions on emissions and pollutants in air and water only because there are more demands on water and air resources than could be simultaneously satisfied in the absence of these restrictions. In other words, if there was no charge or no penalty for dumping pollutants into the air or water, we'd have more people wanting to use the air and water than there would be air or water available for all of our purposes, including being able to drink clean water and to breathe clean air. Since economic analysis examines the allocation of scarce goods, it doesn't apply to free goods. Fortunately, though, there's really no need to be concerned about the allocation of a good if there's more than enough already available to satisfy everyone. However, virtually all goods are scarce goods or economic goods, and as a result, economic analysis remains generally relevant, which is good for the employment prospects of economists. The opposite of an economic good is an economic bad. People are willing to pay to avoid economic bads. Examples of economic bads include garbage, rodent and insect infestation, illness, and crime. For every economic bad, though, there is a corresponding economic good. Waste removal services remove garbage. Pest control services address rodent and insect infestation. Medical care addresses illness. And things like burglar alarms address at least some of the threats associated with crime. We generally focus our attention on the use of the economic good that corresponds to economic bads. Knowing, for example, the level of pest control is, for our purposes, equivalent to determining the level of rodent or insect infestation. So the tools that we will be developing in this class to analyze economic goods also have an application to economic bads.